like to turn us to the book of Second Timothy.
Second Timothy ki laik jai koi amuktang hangtok minase.
And chapter 4. And I would like to read verses 1 to 4. The Lord has laid this verse upon my heart to begin with tonight.
Ngasiki matam numidangi matam asida haudok sanana bagidam prabhu na wapham singa si thamoi thambibani.
This is what Paul the apostle wrote to his spiritual son Timothy.
Ngasi pakol sarpa Paul na ma kithawai gi matsa anupati moti de ikhibas chithini.
And this letter is very important for us in these times. It was written in a time when everything was in a downward trend. Many false prophets and false teachers have gone out. It was a time when everything in the church was deteriorating. And here we find the Apostle Paul with a great burden. Primal thought and mind of God that was given to the church was almost lost. You know, and it was in the background of these things, Paul is writing this letter to his spiritual son. And this is his last letter. I'd like to read from verse 1 to verse 4. I charge thee therefore before God, preach the word and be instant in season, out of season, reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering and doctrine.
Wa adu sandok u kumbi kalen na idana thaurang tauduna layo khangbakan ba amasung tambiba ga loina na chumthok piyo chaiyo amasung pungning thogot piyo.
For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lusts shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears.
Marandi achumba tambiba adu mi singna yaroidaba matam lakani adu gi mahutta mana kong sing hakachabagi maram na makoi na masagi apamba singi matung enna tambiba mi sing makoi gi
tamaka gi damakom singani. And they shall turn away their ears from the truth.
Makoi makoi gi mana kong achumba dagi laitok to na samjin sajen ba wari sing.
And shall be turned unto fables.
Samjin sajen ba wari sing da laisin gani.
But watch thou in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of an evangelist, make full proof of thy ministry.
Adu bunahak ti maram puna makta mitna singu awab khangu evangelist ki thabak tau nahak ki thaugal adu mapung phahalo.
You know, the Lord really reminded me this evening when I was spending time.
Aina matam pija ba matam da isor ga matam len mi na jab matam da masi isor na ingon da ning singhan bikhi bani.
For the time will come. Asu ba
matam adu lakani.
And we are living in those times. Adu
matam adu lakani hai ki ba matam adu dane ekoni hingli bese.
You know, when many would not desire to hear a sound word or teaching.
Madudi mi ayam bana sigumba chumba tambi bese khaurang daba taning daba matam.
You know, and but they will turn to hear something what they desire to hear.
Adu makhoi na makhoi ge mana kong adu taning ba thabak sing adu da pisen ba onsen ba matam.
They would not be open to hear what God has to say to them.
Makhoi da isona haining liba haivi riba adu da makhoi taning ba onsen.
And they shall turn their ears away.
Adu makhoi ge mana kong adu hari ba chum badu da ge leithok
kani. From the truth.
Chum badu da ge leithok kani.
They will turn their ears from the truth.
Makhoi ge mana kong adu chum badu ge leithok kani.
And I want to remind us again tonight. God has given us an opportunity once again to gather together as His people unto Him. And our one agenda ought to be only to hear Him who speaketh. That we may hear Him who speaketh.
Ngang liba mahak putaja bahai basi.
And who said unto His church,
Mahak singlupta haibi riba mahak na.
He that hath an ear, let him hear.
Manakong panba makoi nata sanu.
Let's be therefore open tonight to hear what the Lord has to say.
Maramaduna ishona haibi ningliba asida aikoi ki nakong ase hangko.
You know, I do not want to just give a lot of information to us.
Aina mafa masida ida aikoi da ii pao ya amna pi na na bagida mak leja banate.
Or just give you some thoughts from the Bible. new
thoughts. Bible lagi
my one burden, or the burden that the Lord has laid upon my heart is that God's people in these present times may be established in His truth.
ngasigi matam masida isorgi achumba wahi sida mahakimi singa se sagatcha ba yana nabagi damaktani,
you know, and that's the burden. That's why I'm repeating many things we heard even in the previous weeks.
Paramaduna ni hau khraba chayol singda aikona ta khraba kaya marum aikona aina
hankachari dise. I try to revise some of those things again.
Hari wasing adu aikona amuk hanjanna naina se,
you know, and that's what the Lord has laid upon my heart, that we may be grounded and established in God's word in these present times. Madu aikoi
ishwar ki wahaida sagat cha bache chenna leiba yanana bagi da makcha leiba mata
bache. It's not to gather some more information and knowledge from God's word. Uliba
se asugumba ishwar ki wahaida gi ee pau kari gumba khara gyan phangna na bagi da.
We are living in a time that the original, the true, the old paths have been forgotten.
Madu de aikoi hingliba matam ase achumba ishwar ragi haurak pham oiba adugumba lam ari ba lambi ado kauthokna raba matam dani.
Yes, and therefore there's a great need for God's true people in this hour to be established in the original, the primal, the thoughts of God which God gave to His early apostles.
Mara madu ishwar gi achumba mi singa singa lingai matam gi pakhol chatpa singda pi ki ba ishwar gi maru oi ba achumba sing adu dai da chagat chaba gi matam adu yore.
We are listening to, or we are hearing a kumram, a gospel that is
man-centered.
It is so much centered around man's welfare. You know, the word of God has been very clear to us in these, you know, all these months that which have gone by. The Lord has been speaking to us about our salvation. Our salvation which is progressing. The Lord has been making it very clear that our spirit was saved and our soul is being saved. And our body shall be redeemed. We are in that place where the soul is being saved in this present
time.
Our emotions are being changed to His emotions. Our will is being changed into His will. This is a work we must experience in these present times. You know, and one thing we all need to see, is that really happening with us now?
You
also heard that kingdom of God is now. We also heard that Christ is the Lord and King of our lives. There's a great need for us to move on from Passover to Pentecost and Pentecost unto the Feast of
Tabernacles.
Oh, we thank God for all that God has spoken. And the last couple of weeks, the Lord has been emphasizing that there needs to be a great deliverance in our thought realm. You know, there are many things deposited in our minds. Adu
prabhu na maye gi amna seng nangang bi re madu de ai khoi gi wakhalon ai khoi gi punsi ese dai dai ko na tung khat pa pai khat pa du gumba chum da bo khuding mak singa tu de gi ai khoi ese
we have grown up in an environment where the gospel has been so much man centered. Everything is for you, God is for you, the blessings are for you, the angels are for you, everything is revolving around you.
Ai koi na tarak tona lakhi bawa pau sing adu de miwai bada maru ohen ba khuding mak sing ase miwai bagi ai phana na bagi damak ta laiba ishor gi thaujal bor khuding mak ai koi gi damak ta ai phana na bagi damak ta laiba matam laiba gi wapa adu ai koi na taraga miwai bagi
maru ohen ba thamba
adu ta taraga lakhi bani mai ek
sing na the Lord is not railway port.
Madhu di Prabhu asi railway ki kuli nati aru mayang thangna na bagi damak leri badu nate mahakte.
He is not our servant.
Mahak ekho ki minai nate na.
He is our Lord.
Mahak ekho ki Prabhu ni.
He is not my king now.
Mahak te ai ki ning thau ni hajik hajik.
The kingdom of God is now in my life.
Thor ki ning thau leba adu ai ki punchi ta hajik hajik ori ori gada badi.
Thank God for every word.
Ekho na wahai khudi makki damak thagar le.
And how different this gospel is from all that we have been hearing all these years.
Bahi sangna dege koi na tarak laba wapau singa se dege masi gi wapau singa se kaya da khena khraba no yengo.
May God help us.
Sona tengbang bisanu.
We heard very clearly last week.
Akrabatai olde koi na mayek se na taak re.
That we are called to be his servants or slaves.
Madu de ai koi bu kaubi ki basi maha ki minai oina na bagi damak ta kaubi ki bani.
We have come out of the kingdom of darkness and we have come in the kingdom of God.
Ai koi amam baning
tholei ba kingdom of light.
Amam baning tholei ba ta ki thorak tu na mangal gining tholei ba kai badi iswar gining tholei ba ta changche lakra bani.
You know the scripture makes it very clear.
Pastor namasi mai yamna seng na hairing.
We are his servants.
Ai koi mahak ki minai singni.
He has bought us with a price.
Ram di ai koi bu mahak na mamalama ka loina na lai rakra bani.
We are not our own.
Ai koi sa gi damak oidra bani.
But we are
adu ai koi gi mahak ki oidra bani.
We heard last week.
Bachai bolde koi na tami nakre.
Either way we are not free.
Ani maktai koi amata free oida bani.
We were servants to the kingdom of darkness.
Ai koi ning ta amam baning ta lai ba ki minai sing oiram bani.
We were slaves to sin.
Ai koi paap ta minai oiram bani.
Now we have been delivered from the kingdom of darkness.
Aduga hajik na ai koi amam baning ta lai ba ta ki
kan nakre. And we come into the kingdom of light.
Aduga ai koi mangal gi ning ta lai ba da sangche lakre.
We are king come to the kingdom of
God. Ning ta lai ba da sangche lakre.
Even here we are slaves.
Aduga hajik phawa ma pa masida ai koi hajik suminai ni.
But we are now slaves to righteousness.
Aduga khenari badi hajik ai koi dharma chen bada minai ori bani.
He has paid a great price to buy us.
Ai koi magna mamal sauna pidu na lera khra bani.
And brought us into the kingdom of light.
Aduga ai koi mangal gining tole baru da pushin bira khra bani.
Yes. So we saw God's word very clearly.
Asum ta udun ai koi neshwar gi wahai da mayak chen na ta khra.
We also saw from Luke chapter 17.
Luke kitara tare ta ki choi ko natare.
The example of a servant.
Adu gumba minai gi kudam.
Who has been working in the field of the master.
Mapu adu gi labuk ta lau koi duna thabak shuduna leiramba.
You know, we will come back to that in a while.
Agna ekoi mahari bas.
And we saw that very clearly.
Me yamna seng no ure.
How he had to come back and yet, you know, serve the master at home and give him the dinner.
Thabak wan labuk ta suru raba halak laba matung da yum da halak tu na mahak na mapu adu gi chaklen thaurang tau tu na.
So we saw very clearly in God's word.
Ishwar gi wahai da gi masi mai yam seng ure.
That we are bought with a price.
Adu koi mamal lama ga loina na lera khrabani mamal pi du na lera khrabani.
We are not our own.
Koi isa gi oidra bani.
You know many a time we use this expression.
Ayama matam da budi ai koi na masi gi wahai si si nai.
Only to say we are his.
Ai koi mahak ki ni hai na na ba ki
ma. And he is ours.
Mahak nai koi ki ni hai na na ba ki ta ma.
And we want all the blessings and benefits out of that relationship.
Adun ta udun madu gi mari adu gi ma pa nai koi na yam na ka na ba ku dong cha ba phang ning ba.
But we do not realize.
Adu boi koi na khang je de.
When we say he bought with us with a price.
Mahak nai koi ma mal pi tu na le rak le hai ba si da.
And we are not our own.
Ai koi sa gi oi dre hai ba si da.
We need to realize that we are his possession.
Ai koi na khang je ba dar ka ro se dai koi maha ke lantum ni
we cannot live this life the way we want to live
ai koi hingning ba matung ni koi punsi chi hingba yadra bani
he bought us with a price
ai koi bo maha na mamal pidu na le rakhra bani
he died for us
ai koi damak se vikti bani
that we do not live for ourselves anymore
matu dikari ki no ai bo ai koi sagi dama mohan hingdana na bani
yes so we thank god for all that god spoke to us
so na koi ngang bikra bo kuding mak singa du ki dama ishwar bo thagar le
we have come into a realm where there has been a change of ownership over our lives.
Aikoi na changchi lakli pa mafa masi aikoi gi punsi gi thakta mapu hongdok pa gi mafa maru da changchi lakpani.
We also heard very clearly from the example of the prodigal son.
Aikoi na so adu ko okta ba machanu pa adu gi khuda madu da ure.
He wanted freedom.
Aag na ning tamba pamki.
He wanted to do what he wants to do.
Pantauning ba tau ko pamki bani.
And therefore he wanted to leave the home.
Madu na ma yum thado ning ki bani.
The home where God had kept him.
Shona maak putambi ki bayu madu thado ning ki bani.
He left his father's home.
Maak mapagi yumbu thado ki.
To find himself out as to who he is.
Maak masabu kanano khangtok chena na bagi damak.
And to enjoy his life.
Maak mapunsi nungai ki bani.
But the more freedom he used, the more into bondage he came.
Adu mahang nining tambah hena season hari bermatik mahak phado poibadu resangshin kibani.
In the more freedom he exercised, he moved deeper into slavery in his own life. He was a slave to wrong desires. He was a slave to wrong deeds, activities. And he finally became a little slave. He wanted to find himself in that he lost himself. What he thought to be freedom turned out to be worst kind of slavery in his own life. Now these are very important lessons for all of us. And especially to all the young people. And a second generation in the midst of us. You know, everybody talks about freedom. But remember that freedom is nothing but slavery. We need to know this, brothers and sisters. And may God open our eyes and deliver us from that slavery we have given ourselves to. Remember, only when he returned to his father's home and yielded himself to his father, he found a true freedom in his life. You know, may God help us. I wanted to move on again tonight in the light of this word. And, you know, turn again to Luke 17. And I'll read verse 7 to 10 again. But which of you, having a servant plowing and feeding cattle, will say unto him by and by, when he is come from the field, go and sit down to meat? And will not rather say unto him, make ready wherewith I may sup and gird thyself and serve me till I have eaten and drunken, and afterward thou shalt eat and drink.
Nakoi kanagumbagi lau koi banat raga yaushan ba minai ama leirabadi mahak na lobuk tagi halak pada nakoi na kanagumba ama na mangwanda chatlu sa anana ba pham muhai gadra madugi mahutta mangwanda aigi saglen thaurang tau aina chari ngai da.
Yes. Verse 9, let him thank the servant because he did all those things which are commanded you. Say, we are unprofitable servants. We have done that which was our duty to do.
You know,
as we read this scripture portion here, the parable of Jesus Christ, he spoke unto his disciples. He tells us one thing very clearly through this. He tells us that all our time is his.
Yes.
Now that's very shocking. As far as a slave is concerned, as far as a servant is concerned, yes, all his time is the master's. Yes. That is what Jesus Christ was projecting by in and through this parable.
Yes.
Now, that's very shocking for us in a time such as this in which we are living. Adu
koi na hingliba asigumba matam asida idadi masigi wa ase taab matam da yamna ngakpa phawi.
But the Lord gave this parable to his disciples.
Adu prabhu na masigi pandam singa se masigi wari ase.
To tell them one thing very clearly.
Karigumba mama ek sekna hai nana bagi hai kirani.
Their lives are in every way, you know, it's to be given to the master. That's why he said again towards the end, so likewise, your lives too. Yes. I would like to read it from the J.B. Phillips translation. We won't translate for, you know, we will not interpret into other language. If any of you has a servant plowing and looking after the sheep, are you likely to say to him when he comes in from the fields, come straight in and sit down to your meal? Or are you more likely to say, get my supper ready, change your coat, wait until I eat and drink, and then when I have finished, you can have your meal? Do you feel particularly grateful to your servant for doing what you tell him? I don't think so. This is what Jesus said. I don't think so. It is the same with yourselves. When you have done everything that you are told to do, you can say, we are not much good as servants, for we have only done what we ought to do. Now, this is what Jesus said.
Hajik masi prabhu jesu krista nani hai ke
basi. It is the same with yourself.
Na koi jesu masi chap mana bani na koi
tu. So as I said, the Lord, you know, says through this parable one thing very categorically to all his disciples today in this 21st century.
Aina so aise kre madu di prabhu na masi ma ki sevok sing da hai ki ba mathang manau ka
idana ki. I may sound very narrow minded.
Aina hari basinga se wakal yam na pik pa mawong man ba yai.
But remember, the one who said these words, he said it not only for the disciples then, but for all his disciples who will follow after him.
Adu bo hari ba wapam singa si mata madu ki sebok sing ta khakta hai ki bana te adu bo prabhu jesu krista bu ilaka da batung ilaka da
batung for all the times to come. Laka da
ba tam puna makta ma ki tung inga
da bo singa for he bled and died on the cross
magna I ta bi du na cross si bi khraba
and rose again from the dead
adu magna hi si bi da ki hingat khraba
ascended to the heavenly
adu sarga ji mapam sing da ma ka
ka send his holy spirit ma
ki thawa sing ba thabi raktu na
for this precious work ma ki
mamalu ra ba thabok singa de
ma deliver us from the power of darkness.
Amam bagi pangal dagi kanbina nana bagi damak.
That we do not be slaves anymore to darkness. Madu
dai koi amam bagi minai amu han oidana nana bagi damak.
We may not live for ourselves anymore. Ai koi
isa gi damak amuk han makha tan hingdana nana bagi damak.
Live unto him who died.
Adu ai koi gi damak sibi kraba ma gi damak hingna
nana bagi damak. So may God help us.
Sona teng
we would have a great difficulty to accept this word.
Masi gi wahai ese lokshin madana koi gi damak te amna
lugu tolam bai. Remember, it is the one who bled and died for us who says this. Adu
ma ha masi bu hai ki ba sidai ko ki da ma I ta
adu sidai ki ma ha hai ki ba
masi Joy Thomas ki wahai na te.
This is God's word. Take the word, sit down for yourself and seek the face of God.
Why is it na na put pa ka lo lo du na ishor gi
ma and see what the Holy Spirit tells you further.
Adu thawa ese gona nang bu ching bi rakani.
The anointing that is on you will teach you.
Na wona lai ki ba tambi ki ba pibi ki ba anointing adu na nang bu tambi rakani.
So the Lord Jesus says,
Jesus Christ na hai.
All our time is
ko gi ma tampu na mag ma ha ki ni hai na hai ri.
The 8 hours we work.
I go pungni pan thabok shui.
The 8 hours we work.
I go pungni pan thabok shuri.
The 8 hours we sleep.
Pungni panam na tumli.
The other 8 hours also that we have.
I go ki pungni panam
suri bado. It is all his.
Maha ki ni hari basinga
do. It may be a shock to us.
I go masi nangak bai ai khanghan bai ai masi taru matam da niksing bio.
That's what Jesus was trying to tell through this parable. Maha ki
masi ki pandam giwari asi da ki maha na koi dhaining
libe. You know, perhaps after we return home.
I go na yum da halba halaba matung da
suno bai. After slogging for the day in our workplace.
I go ki thabok shupam da I go na suru raba matung.
We may have a feeling within our hearts.
I go ki thamoi da de ko na sumna pharam bai ai.
I am putting it in our modern day words.
Aina masigi matam chanariba matam masigi ano matam masida haizin ningi.
I will get back home.
Aina yum da halaga.
I am very tired. I will have a good shower or bath, whatever it is.
Phajana iru ja thok lage.
And then I will have my dinner.
Aina chaglen jarani.
I will relax.
Kothara hai pet kothara.
I will watch for some time what's happening in the world today? What's happening in India? What is the latest about COVID? What is about the latest strain of this COVID? You know, what's happening with the farmers? Strike? Or I will watch some sports. And then I will go to bed. That may be my resolve and my feeling. And some would say, well, tonight there's a meeting. But I deserve a rest. And my God knows it. He knew how hard the day was. And how difficult the day was. Though my leaders may not understand me. They never understand me. Because they have no other job but this job. And therefore,
I am
not satisfied. I deserve
it.
Yes. And one meeting I already attend during the week. That is good enough. And I will attend other meetings if I am able to. I deserve some rest. The Lord knows. Now that may be my thing. Yes, the day is coming to a close.
I want to tell you,
if the Lord would overhear that, the Lord would ask, you deserve what, Mr. Slave?
Mr. Minai, nang na matik chaba phangba da matik chaba to kari neba, nang na tauba matik chaba to nang na kari hai kiba.
You deserve.
Nang na kari matik chai hai ba?
Dear brother, we deserve nothing.
Na kari so matik chaba lai tabani. I koi di maram de koi mahaki Minai ni.
We are his servants. We are bought with a price. He paid a heavy price to bring you and me out of that dungeon. We often sing that song, He lifted me up from that horrible miry
clay.
Now we sing that song, but we do not realize what it took for Him to pull us out of that miry clay. You know, He paid His own blood for that. You know, His body was broken and torn. Please understand. We have been, we have heard a man-centered gospel. Our minds are filled with that, the Babylonian filth. As we heard on Sunday morning, that holy place, every filth has to be cleansed out of us. Oh, may God open our eyes, brothers and sisters. And I want to tell you, if we are able to come into the light of this word, it's going to revolutionize and change your life and my life. All are ours, time belong to Him. It does not belong to us. It's not the governments. It does not belong to the government. It does not belong to the boss. It does not even belong to your family. It is not yours. It's not your family. It's not your government. It's not your bosses. It's not ours. It belongs to the Lord who bought you and me with a price. Yes. You and I may be thinking that. What is this man saying? You may be saying, thinking that what is this man saying? That may be your inward reaction as you are hearing this word. There could be a reaction even within me. Could this be practical? Sometimes people tell me. Sometimes people ask me or tell me. How can this be practical? All that I want to say to you is, take this word and take it to the Lord in prayer. There you will know how this word is going to be practical in your life. More than what I would say, the Holy Spirit will show you how this word can be practical in your life. Because it is God's word. And it will do a great work in us. So the servant in Jesus' parable, while he was yet in the field, maybe he was thinking about, I visualize like this. When this servant was in the field, he may be thinking about the master. He was not thinking about himself, but he was thinking. He was not thinking, I will take my shower and then I will eat my food, or I will have a good coffee, and I'll have some snack, and then I will take some. Not he was thinking, but he was thinking, what shall I prepare for Master tonight? What shall I prepare for the Master tonight? While he was plowing the field, yes, when he was tending the sheep there, he was thinking of what shall I do for my master tonight? What dinner shall I prepare for him? Yes. Shall I make him some rice and dal? And some chicken fry? Or chicken curry? Then suddenly he realized, oh yes, yesterday he had already chicken. I will make something else for him today. All through the time when he was plowing the field and tending the things there, taking care of the field, his thoughts were always on the master, what he ought to be doing for the master. Oh, I will make for him some lamb curry or mutton curry. And I will make some cabbage, you know, for him. Oh, but then he realized, my master doesn't cabbage so much, doesn't like it. Maybe he will eat little bit, but that is not his liking. Yes, so I will make him some beans. Now I may sound very funny tonight, but what I'm trying to convey to us is, while he was yet doing the master's work, his thoughts were always on the master. He was thinking about the master, not himself. He was not thinking about himself, but he was thinking about his master. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How precious that is, brothers and sisters. Even while he is yet working in the field of the master, His thoughts were still on the master. How precious that is. That is what a true servant is. This is what Jesus was trying to picture or bring forth in and through this parable. That is the picture of the true servant that the Lord was speaking forth here in this parable. And I want to say tonight, my brothers and sisters, where is your mind? What is your mind filled with? What is our mind filled with? Through the whole day. As I shared a while back, 8 hours for work. 8 hours for many other things. How much time do this master receive from us? Please. The 21st century slaves, the slaves so-called disciples, the so-called believers, they have no time for this master. Rather, the master should be available 24 hours. Is that justified? Is that right? Don't you realize it's lopsided idea? Don't you think it's
asantulan?
Yeah. My dear brothers and sisters, take your 8 hours sleep. Take your 8 hours of work. You still have, and I have 8 hours left. Is this Lord to beg and wait and plead with you and me for time? Are we not playing with words with this Savior who bled and died and paid a great price for us? Are we justified? Please. This is my humble plea to all of us and to myself.
Yes.
Are we justified? Who is slave? Who is servant? We are spoiled children. We were raised up with a gospel which is man-centered. The original is lost. The old ways are forsaken by the present day Christianity. The servant, while yet working in the master's field, yet thinking of the master, what a tremendous thought that is. The Lord is trying to convey through this parable.
What
our minds are filled with, brothers and sisters. Is it filled with his word which he has spoken? Are your thoughts about what God has spoken to you? What you must do in the light of that word? Are your thoughts sprinkled with his thoughts and his word? Your thoughts are sprinkled with. Yes, in your thought life. Yes, in your thought life. Yes. Is your word working in your thought realm? Thinking about, Lord, how can this word be a reality in my family? How can it work in my own life? I may be working in my office. I may be traveling. I may be doing something else. Where is my mind? Is he as someone who is filling our mind and our thoughts? Is the Lord who is filling my mind and my thoughts? How could my children come into this light? Oh Lord, help my children to walk this way. What should I do? What should we do as parents? Are your thoughts in those realms where God, you want God to work in the light of His Word? When you read the book of Job in chapter 1, he was concerned about his children. He said, you know, my children, if they have done anything wrong, I will offer sacrifices unto God for their sake. And he continued to do so. Here was a father whose thoughts were filled with the thoughts of God for his children. How they should walk in the ways of God. How they should be separated. Is the word working in us? Lord, what shall I do with this word? How is it going to work out in this present situation? How is it going to work out in my office situation? Will this satisfy you? Will this bring glory to you, Father? Where are our thoughts? Where are our thoughts? As for this servant, his thoughts were always on the master. What will please him? What will cause him to be satisfied? What he will take delight in? What is our thought? There's a gathering today, Lord. There's a gathering today. Lord, help me. I must worship you. Yes. And I ought to, Lord, meet with you today evening. I know I am at work. But I want to prepare my heart for that, Lord. Despite all the business in my workplace, I want to keep my heart towards this evening gathering. What a heart that is. What a thought realm that is. Lord, I'm anxious to hear you tonight. What will you speak to me? I want to hear you, Lord. And I do not want to miss your voice. Will my God be satisfied with my praise? Will my God be happy with my worship? My brothers and sisters, that is the thought of a servant, a slave. All the time thinking about the master. What will satisfy my
heart?
What he will take delight in? His satisfaction is all that the servant or the slave is concerned about. My brothers and sisters, I want to say, all our time belongs to him. How sad it is to see the lives of
believers.
To see our own lives. Take your 8 hours of work. Take your 8 hours of sleep. Still 8 hours.
Remember,
the 24 hours belong to the master. That's one thing the Lord is very clearly conveying through this.
Madhuni masigi pautaki wari asida prabhu na hari basida hining liba.
Oh my God. Speak to hari basa. I khoi
ki thamoi da isor nangang bi.
This is not about full time ministry.
Masidi thagol tori ba missing khaki da magnate.
This is for every disciple
prabhu
of Jesus Christ.
Prabhu Jesus Christ ki sevok makini masidi.
Yes.
May God. So ne khoi bateng bang bisanu.
Saints.
Rogi mi oisa.
Often we call him Lord. But our attitude is that he is a slave. We must be delivered in our thoughts. Our minds have to be cleansed and purified by the word and the spirit. We must be delivered, brothers and sisters. Let's not go by maturity. If you have any doubt, don't go by what majority people are saying. Go to God's word. Be like the Bereans. Search the word and see what, if this is the truth or not. No. You search the scripture, you will find the truth. Yes. We should say, Lord, only when we are ready to give ourselves to him and be his slave.
Only then we can say or call him really.
Yes, we should have that attitude and that submission. It may not be 100%, you know, out working out in our lives now. But we must that condition of heart within us. You know, when I call him Lord, we must be ready to give ourselves to him and be his servant. He said to the servant, you know, as it says here in J.B. Phillips, let me just read it. Yes. Yes. Aren't you likely to say, get my supper ready, change your coat. Come on, prepare for me to eat.
I gi chanana bagi damak nang phiron hongdok tu na thorang tau
You prepare for me to eat. Properly clothe yourself. Yes. You are working in the field. Now change your clothes. Yes. Wait until I eat and drink. And then when I have finished, you can have your meal. Yes. Afterward. When I have finished. When I have finished. Yes. Afterward. You could eat.
Saints,
we cannot be his disciples if we do not give ourselves as his
servants.
Yes. Now that's very, very important. The Lord therefore said, therefore, he said, it is the same with yourselves. When you have done everything, it is the same with yourselves. One thing the Lord conveyed very clearly through this parable. The satisfaction of the servant is to see the Lord satisfied.
Yes,
that was conveyed very clearly through this parable. It is the same with yourselves. When you have done everything,
yes.
The satisfaction of the servant is to see the Lord, the Master satisfied. Yes, dear brothers and sisters, we are to yield our bodies as a living sacrifice to Him. We have heard this many number of times. We have to yield our bodies as a living sacrifice.
Yes.
Then when we have brought our bodies to Him as a living sacrifice, He will be satisfied. That is why the writer, the Apostle Paul says, as a reasonable service unto
God.
That is what he will be satisfied. This is his dinner. Bringing our lives, you know, as a living sacrifice, as a whole burnt offering, leaving nothing for ourselves, holy burnt or given unto Him. That alone satisfies
Him.
This is His dinner. He consumes it. And that's what we see in the burnt offering. The whole sacrifice is consumed by the fire of the Lord. He consumes it. That is his dinner. He takes delight in it. He is satisfied in it. How true it is about Jesus Christ. The Heavenly Father said, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased, I am satisfied.
Hallelujah.
Jesus Christ offered himself as sacrifice through the Spirit. He was a burned, whole burnt offering. All through his life. And finally on the cross of Calvary. My brothers and sisters, may God help us. This is not high sounding doctrine. This is the gospel of Jesus Christ. He preached to his disciples. And it is so sad today. A different gospel is being preached.
May God help us
and deliver us. We are the slaves of the Master, even Jesus Christ, who bought us with a great price. Now Jesus ends the story with these words. He asks this question, do you feel particularly grateful to your servant for doing what you tell him?
No,
and what was the reply of Jesus?
Reply do karino.
I don't think so. In other words, he said, no. You are not going to thank him for that. So we don't need to be thanked for the things we do unto the Lord.
Yes.
So the Lord said, so you too. Yes. It is the same with yourselves. Yes. It is the same with yourselves. You have only done that which you ought to have done. Yes. As the J.B. Phillips says, when you have done everything that you are told to do, you can say, we are not so much, we are not much good as servants, for we have only done what we ought to do. We have only done what we ought to have done. And so when a person does all that the Lord commands him, the Lord gives him at last a diploma. And that diploma reads, unprofitable servant. That is what is lettered in that diploma. That is what is written in that diploma, in that certificate. Unprofitable servant. I'm going to conclude tonight. But today, in this 21st
century,
we are totally upside down. 21st
century,
people call themselves reverends. Most reverend. Most reverend.
Most
reverend.
Reverend.
Yeah. No. Reverend is not das. Who said?
Nasidi missing a missing the Ikai Kumna but the Matikcha, but reverend, I would say missing the people Ming Tonore, Sorgi Mingni.
No, don't bring that. Yeah, you know, reverend so and so,
reverend,
most reverend so and so, and so on and so forth.
Zumba, quite again, Ikai Kumna but the Matikcha, but reverend, I know Nasidi missing the Pira Ming Tolore, Kaunere.
People announce like this.
Missing the Susumana Lautoe program Thoramda.
And now the great servant of God will come.
Aziki, Sorgi Atoiba, Manayado, Laglagani Haina.
Music is playing. Spotlights are focused on the man. And there comes the great servant. It is all a kind of joke. If that man is great, then he is not a servant. You cannot be a great servant. If you are great, then you are not a servant. And if he is a servant, he is not great. The Lord said,
"Go,
gird thyself, serve me until I have eaten and drunk. After that, ye shall eat
and drink."
And in closing, I want to say, our eating and our drinking and our celebration is when the kingdom is established on the earth. Listen carefully. Our eating and drinking and our celebration is when the kingdom of God is established upon this earth. But now here on this earth, our eating, our refreshments, our joy, when we see Jesus satisfied in our lives. Yes.
Maduni.
Hallelujah. Oh, may that register. I would say this again. Our eating and drinking and our celebration is when the kingdom of God is established upon this earth. But now here on this earth, our eating and our refreshings or our refreshments and our joy will be when we see Jesus satisfied with our lives. Our eating, our joy is when the Lord is satisfied over my life.
Prabhu na ai nangi punsi da pelaba kanu da khakta laibane.
He is satisfied with what he is doing in our life.
Mahana penja basidi aiko gi punsi da mahana thabak ta ubadani.
He is satisfied with what he has done in our lives. He is satisfied with what he is able to do through our lives. When he is satisfied, that is going to be our eating and
drinking.
Our refreshments. Our joy. That the Lord is satisfied. The satisfaction of the Lord.
Prabhu ki penja badudi.
That is
madu ai gi nuai bani.
I would like to close.
Ai namaste lo
Mahaki
Prabhu ni.
And we are.
Ai koi na mahaki minai singni ok na na ba.
To usher in His kingdom.
Pithvi esi gi lai pithvi gi lai mai thak sida mahaki ning thole baktu ok na na ba ai koi minai ni.
All of us. Remember. We are bought with the
Ningsing bio ai koi chaurpa mamalama piduna leira khrabani
ai koi
matam puna mak mahakini
all over
matam puna mak mahakini
my god
shone koi bukan bisanu
our selfish
ai koi sagita oi ba punsi mahing asidagi
Ningsing bio
mahakti prabhu ni mahakini thauni mahak namapuni.
He bought us. May we be delivered from every other mentality. And may God bring us in to that place of cleansing and purifying our thought realm.
Let
every filth be removed from us. May God help us. Shall we all stand up in His presence.
Haki mangda, ekoi loi na maglev khatmi narasi.